Never have I ever hated someone because of a false rumor.
Oh, I have. I totally have. And some false rumors have gone through the roof. So those ones I've definitely hated.
Never have I ever stolen something from a hotel room.
Not true.
Never have I ever, lastly, lied to my partner about something silly.
You must be joking. Of
you
course
haven't?
I have.
Silliest thing if you can recall and tell us.
What, silliest?
Thing that you have lied to your partner about.
Oh, that's a secret, baby. I don't think even he needs to know now.
Always a good time when you have the fabulous Sushmita Sen, Chandrachur Singh and Rama Advani to you.
Thank you, Sushmita.
A decade to see you on screens. Why so long? My last interview with you was in 2009.
Can you imagine?
At that time, Pooja was 6 years old.
You are lovely. You are a man after my own heart. Thank you so much.
And by the way, might I add, I was in diapers.
Can I say I was one of the many people who applauded Sushmita when she became Miss Universe. So I belong to that generation.
You know,
the crowning.
Just giving you a hug in person. You've always been very warm and extremely kind and a real heart supporter. Thank you for that.
Always.
It's wonderful to talk to you after so many years.
बताओ 10 साल क्यों लग गए?
अच्छी चीजों को वक्त लगता है, you know, and I think that it's you can't call that pressure. You just have to call it the love of people. I just knew that after you take a sabbatical for 10 long years, you can't just come back with let's do something. You know, you have to come back with something that has substance. That they can look at and say, now, we love this comeback. This is exciting, you know. By God's grace, Mr. Ram Madhwani and his entire team and Ram Madhwani Films and Hotstar Disney Plus gave me that platform cumulatively to be able to do this. And this day means the world to us. By the way, today we crossed 15 million on the trailer. I'm
awesome.
So sorry.
Okay, it's a lovely freeze.
But tell me, Sushmita, do you relate to Arya? Because she's badass and she's also someone who lives by her own rules. And you're someone who's always lived by her own rules. So did she resonate with you?
Completely. Completely. I think that I must tell you this. When the script was written and when we shared it for the first time, when it was shared with me for the first time, there was an arc and a graph to Arya, which was very different. And then this is the sign of a brilliant director. He met me, we did the workshops together, he got the feedback that this one exudes strength, so her vulnerability will have to be controlled, you know. And so the script was then made with an arc that suited the actor. I mean, incredibly done. So yes, I resonate with it because there is so much of Sushmita and Arya coming together in this series. A lot of people have noticed it too, and they've said, oh my God, like a lot of my dear friends and people who've known me for years got saying, we've seen you play characters before, with some we connected with, some we didn't. But this is the first time I feel like I know you. You're palpable. You're so much of the real you. So that's been wonderful, Pooja. Very excited.
That's exactly what I felt also when I saw the trailer. I said, this is Sushmita. Sushmita, Arya, they're like entwined. I mean, they're so similar. And coming to Mr. Chandrachur Singh, where did you disappear after Reluctant Fundamentalist? We didn't. Dono ko waise Ram Madhwani ne dono ko leya hai, pakad kar.
Ji. No, I'm very grateful for this opportunity to make a debut on the digital format in the kind of setup that this is. And मैं गायब तो ऐसे हो गया क्योंकि मेरी जो पर्सनल लाइफ थी दैट टुक प्रेसिडेंस ओवर माय प्रोफेशनल ऑब्लिगेशंस. सो मैंने सोचा कि जब सही समय आएगा और सही अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलेगी तो मैं ऐसा काम करूंगा. एंड माय हार्ट वाज टेलिंग मी एंड आई लिसन टू माय हार्ट अ लॉट वाज टेलिंग मी दैट दिस इज द राइट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू यू नो रीस्टार्ट थिंग्स. एंड सो यू नो इट जस्ट फेल्ट परफेक्ट. I I'm a huge admirer of Ram's work. I really enjoy Nirja. And I was overjoyed when he gave me this wonderful opportunity. And Sushmita and me were supposed to work quite a while ago. For some reasons, that work didn't fructify. And then after that, when this opportunity came, it was a beautiful serendipity. And something which, samay se pehle cheez nahi hoti, I believe this was the right time for things to happen.
And do you know there is a meme circulating that it's Shashi Tharoor and not you?
Yes.
So now we know that Chandrachur can very easily be a part of his biopic also. I must tell you, we haven't brought Chandrachur back to his most celebrated craft. We've also brought him for the first time on social media.
Awesome.
He's been away from that for all these years. So very happy for you, Chandrachur. Finally, you are back where you belong.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And coming to the director, Nirja was beautiful. My only memories is that I howled and I howled and I howled and I didn't recover. And Arya, is she also inspired by someone you knew, a real life character, or is...
Okay, so first I need to make one correction, which is I do have a co-creator, Sandeep Modi. I do have three directors. There's Sandeep Modi, Vinod Rawat, and myself. I would love to take all the credit, but it would not be nice of me to do so. As far as who is Arya inspired by, no, it's not a real life story, but I have very strong women surrounding me. My wife, Amita, and my co-producer from Ramadhani Films, and in fact, a lot of the unit, my EP, my editors, these are all strong women, and they are very, very protective women. So I think that the sort of 360-degree-ness of Arya, which is she's a mother, at the same time she is somebody who's strong, at the same time she's vulnerable, and she'll go to any extent to protect her family and her children. These are some of the women that I have seen around me. And that is really what Arya embodies. Not to say that it is a woman-centric show, but still, it is about a powerful character.
And you got the perfect actor to play Arya also, because she embodies just that. She's a mom who will go to any levels too. I mean, she'll fight against the odds. But all of you, just tell me, how has OTT changed Bollywood? Because, you know, a lot of actors are now looking at this platform also. How has it changed the industry?
Sushmita?
It's become a very strong reason for all of us who were not finding the kind of work that inspired us to come back. It's a huge compliment. I mean, it's got content and it's got creative people who, you know, the very viewership of what we are trying to create and the liberties we can take to tell stories differently, to not follow any particular formula, is wonderful because it is progressive, as Arya is. When you see the series, you'll recognize, Sir said it beautifully. So not Sir, he doesn't like that. Captain said it beautifully. he says that when you look at Arya as a character, you go beyond a gender bias. You no longer say, what a strong woman. You say, what a strong character,
yeah.
You know? And to build that, in you and I both know, Pooja, in Hindi films, it's always about, acha, it's a woman carrying the film on her shoulders. Oh, ho, ho. Is it a woman-centric subject? Oh, ho, ho. So there's panic with that. Here on an OTT platform, you're like celebrating it. I mean, I keep going back to the fact that the amount of love and appreciation just the trailer has received tells you that the younger generation is all about OTT. I mean, I love the big screen. I'm a product of that. I love cinema. But there is something very intimate about being in your home at the click of a button and you're there. And you're there for 9 hours of binge watching. What fun is that, man? So I think it has on many levels, content level, consumer level, creative levels. It's changed it all in a very, very big way.
And also on what I call as the Friday Mafia.
Yes, oh yes.
Reputations cannot be built on one Friday. That is
see
not
why right. I love this man. I love this man.
I so agree
on
with that.
Sunset, this is such a match. Like, I have waited my whole life in this profession to meet him. We think alike. We believe in the work rather than the paraphernalia around it.
Yeah.
You know, it's amazing to meet someone. I'm in love with him. Sorry, I interrupted.
No, that's okay. And Friday Mafia, honestly, and both you and Chandrachur have borne the brunt of the Friday Mafia too. I so agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't have a return of investment being bums on seats equals to Friday Mafia equals to your last hit, and therefore you were great last Friday, but guess what? This Friday you're nobody. And guess, and you know, I have not been at the receiving end of this because I've just made literally Neelja, but before that I made Let's Talk, which only six people saw in any case. But
I loved it. I saw it and I loved it.
Okay, so that's one person here. So
seven people, yeah.
Yeah. However, the thing is that my own reputation has thankfully not suffered from the Friday Mafia and the return of investment syndrome. But certainly these two hugely talented actors and these two people who should not have been at the receiving end of that have been at the receiving end of that for sure.
Chandrachur, what do you say? I mean, you gave us brilliant movies like there was Matches, there was Tere Mere Sapne, there was Josh. So what do you have to say to that? Is this basically a boon and, you know, puts the industry in its place also, when talent is concerned.
It is a boon. You get a chance to develop a content-based show which goes into, say, for example, 9 episodes. You get a chance to build on characters, and it's more character-driven, it's more content-driven. And I think Sushmita has said it perfectly. And I don't think there's anything more that I can really add to it. She's put it across very well.
And we saw Sushmita dancing as if there's no tomorrow on the sets of Arya, obviously.
You saw?
Yeah. Yes, she loved every moment of being there. Now, after Arya, will we see you more or do we wait for another 10 years?
No. So the thing is, I am a little spoiled, Pooja. I have been telling Mr. Ram Madhvani that I don't know how I'll be able to work with anyone after this experience. It's been insane. You have to understand that for me, I went back to studying or school. Back to school after 24 years of being in the business. I went to my first ever workshop and sat down wondering, oh my God. And I thought, I knew this. But you know, when you go with the method that he uses as a director, he has the 10 ways to reach the truth. It's a concept you have to read about. It's fascinating, okay? So you may be acting, but the feeling has to be felt for it to be communicated. Therefore, there's a continuation of a feeling by not cutting a shot in the middle. So if you have a 2-page scene or a 10-page scene, if you have 2 actors in it or 20 actors in it, nobody cuts the take. You do the entire scene in one go.
Awesome.
And you have 3 or 4 cameras capturing it at any given point of time. And that just allows you to perform, to feel. And sometimes you feel it, sometimes you don't feel it. And when you don't, guess what he does? He doesn't tell you to feel it. He changes the line, he changes the vibe, he changes everything for you to feel it. I mean, where am I going to get that again, man?
Awesome. And it's been 24 years. And also somebody told me it was 20 years of Josh. You guys are like...
Yeah.
Lambi race ke ghode jaise ko kehte hain.
They're antiques.
But how has the lockdown been treating you all? Any lockdown confessions coming our way from the fabulous threesome?
Matlab?
Lockdown koi confessions bata do. I'm not asking you how is the lockdown treating you. Aap confessions de do. Ek lockdown confessions bata do main.
Oh, sir, you start. I mean, Captain, you start.
Okay, no, Captain, no, sir. Please don't do this to me, ma'am. Well, we've been working actually very hard. We've been blessed because we finished our shooting before lockdown, but we did have to do our entire post editing, dubbing. Both Chandrachur and Sushmita have been dubbing, and you know, it's been also a major thing for them. At the same time, you cannot complain about this because it's something that has kept our minds and our hearts occupied while the whole world is going through what they're going through. And so it has been, we are yet today also, I'm yet doing the music, all this is all happening. And I suddenly get a music just before the interview. So I have to see that. So all this is happening. I'm happy that we've got this work. Work is something which keeps us going. It's what has kept all of us going for so many years. And also what happens is that there were 588 people who were part of our show. And we are here because they were there. And I want to go back and I want to support them. I want to start shooting again because we support each other in the economics of our own lives and in not just the economics, but in the, you know, in how shall I say, the hungry hearts of our own lives. We're all hungry hearted people.
Sushmita, she's been entertaining us with her TikTok videos, the family, partner, everybody together.
I'm not on TikTok. I don't like
some nice videos, sorry.
Instagram
mein but TikTok videos nahi the. Sorry. People try to put up TikTok videos, but your videos are so fine. So yeah, okay. They're very entertaining though.
Oh, thank you. I'm so glad you've been watching this. It's been a lovely way for me to stay in touch with everybody I love.
So any lockdown confessions from the San home?
Well, we thought we were dealing with it really nicely. Like we were very zen about it, the San family. But off late, you know, the good thing I think the government did is kind of give us a 2-week window at a time. So we thought, wow, only 2 weeks, we'll be okay. And yeah, 3 months just went by. Now I'm a little restless because this is such an important time for Arya. And we really, really wish there were moments when we could actually go feel the human touch because this moment won't come back. And now I'm a little restless. I have to admit, now the Zen part of me has kind of gone out the window and I want to just be there rather than be on the screen.
True, looking forward to it. And Chandra, to you.
My son was in boarding school. So it's nice to spend time with him. But, you know, there are pluses and minuses and one just wishes the world becomes a better place, a happier place after all the challenges that we've seen. And, well, I've stayed with the memories of Arya because when we were, I remember such a yearning to get a feeling right or the truth the moment, right? As Sushmita said, there were no cuts, but there was no action either. We had to feel and start the scene to begin. And then we revved ourselves up emotionally to a point with the entire assistance of a wonderful creative team to be able to, as actors, emotionally feel a scene. There is no use of glycerin in Arya. Everything, I think, has come from the heart and it has come very soulfully and truthfully because we've actually managed to feel the scene with the help of the entirety.
Anyways, before we go, we have got a short little rapid fire for Sushmita. Never have I ever hated someone because of a false rumor.
I have. I totally have. And some false rumors have gone through the roof. So those ones I've definitely hated.
Never have I ever stolen something from a hotel room.
Not true.
Never have I ever, lastly, lied to my partner about something silly.
You must be joking.
Of you haven't?
I have.
Silliest thing if you can recall and tell us.
What, silliest?
Thing that you have lied to your partner about.
Well, that's a secret, baby. I don't think even he needs to know now.
Anyways, thank you so much. Such a pleasure talking to the three of you.
Well, and you're such a fun Pooja. Thank you so much.
Sushmita and Chandrashu, don't make us wait so long. Yeah, I mean, honestly, want to see you more often.
Well, watch Arya. Let's get season 2.
Exactly. Thank you so much.
Love you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you. All the best. Bye.